Hi, I'm the Magpie.
And I'm Jax.
And this is Mondays with Magpie. So welcome back. We've been
on hiatus.
Yes. On hiatus. Senior moment. We've been on hiatus for a while because my kitchen has been under reconstruction. We've been having a great big reno going. So here we are.
And it's going to look so good. Can't wait to film in there.
Jacqueline
calls grouting
it,
today.
Yes, she the grouting, the backsplash. They call it, she calls it her surrogate kitchen.
It's my surrogate kitchen and I love it.
So here we are back on our hot plate, 110 meals. And today we are doing chicken fajitas.
Yum. Ay, ay, ay.
Ay, ay, ay. And it's so simple, David. Jacqueline's husband, who is on tour with Finding Neverland. This one, we don't even need a recipe. It's that simple.
Wow.
Yeah, I know.
That's great.
Yeah. So you're going to go to the store, your food store, all right? And you will buy corn tortillas, soft.
You should buy whole wheat, dear.
Yeah, these are whole wheat corn tortillas. I bought salsa, guacamole, sour cream, chicken. I have chicken tenders, but if you really want to cheap it out, you can buy one chicken breast and you cut them so that you have little fingers, okay? And here is the big ingredient. This is an ad for the spice company.
Maybe we'll just cover it.
It's
never know.
It's skillet sauce, and you find it in the soup aisle, all right? It's fajita skillet sauce. It's the easiest thing in the whole wide world to make. You also need to buy a pepper or two. I like red and yellow. What kind do you like?
I like red and yellow.
Red, I think they're sweeter than the green,
yeah, I think so too.
Green ones. Yeah.
Yeah.
So
red and yellow.
Okay. Now we're ready to begin. That's it. That's all you need. So no recipe for this one, David.
Onion. Did you say onion?
Oh, onion.
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 How do you say onion in Spanish?
I don't know.
Los años.
Los, yes.
Oh, sorry.
Onions.
I'll work on that.
I'll Google that.
By the way, you may be seeing a little occasional, where's Coralie, my little daughter? Here, come here. Come here. She's under the table right now. You might have seen her walk in.
There she is.
Occasionally
there's
I see
Cora.
All right.
So anyway, there we are. All right, so now the first thing you have to do is put your skillet on and let it get hot, all right? But keep an eye on it so that it doesn't do anything nasty. But before we do anything, Jacqueline, okay. Step this way, my dear.
Okay.
Just like this. All right, now, I went to a craft fair and I bought this really, really sharp knife.
Wow.
So we're gonna try it. All right, I will show you how to do one.
Okay.
All right, so this is a pepper. We cut off the top, we cut off the bottom. It's really, really easy. And then you get in there with your fingers and you pull out the seed pod and you put it in your trash bowl.
That's good for compost because it could grow next year and then you would have surprise peppers.
Surprise peppers.
I had 8 more pumpkins this year and some tomatoes. If you don't turn your compost, you get surprise garden.
You get surprise garden. Okay, Jax. Now we're gonna cut these in strips. I leave it to you. And I'll get
strips
this one.
Strips like this?
Yes. Okay. Yes, strips just like that.
I've eaten fajitas before.
Yeah.
I never.
And when you cut your pepper, cut it from the inside, not from the skin side, because it's easier when you cut it from this side.
Get all the little white part out, because that's bitter and doesn't taste good, so.
I always feel guilty because, you know, we use other people's recipes sometimes. Well, most of the time. Every recipe is someone else's recipe. And then you just kind of put your own little spin on it.
Can we use this too?
Yeah, yeah. Use all the pepper.
Right.
Waste not, want not. All right, onions. Here's how you cut the onion.
Okay.
Just cut it in half. Lay it on so there's a half moon showing, all right? And then chop it. Okay, here, use this one.
I'm staying very mature with the moon reference. That's what I want to know.
All right, go on. Chop it. Nice slices.
I think
She's
it's important.
Very, very good.
I think it's important to let everyone know when I'm showing maturity.
One onion. And one pepper you have to do, but you can do two peppers if you feel like you want more vegetables. It's a way to stretch it. So if your neighbor comes in from the next room, your friend, then, you know. Now, all right, these are all prepped, all right? So now we're gonna prep the chicken. Now, not on the wooden board because we need to be able to really scrub it, so you get yourself another board or the coffee table with glass. I don't know, whatever you're working on. All right?
Yeah.
Now, this is a chicken tender. All right? It's too big. So, we are going to pack it into three pieces. So, we have nice strips, all right? Like fajita size strips. All right, so first, so important that you prep everything, because once you get started, it just goes. This is like the easiest recipe in the whole wide world, and you will all be eating fajitas from now until next Friday.
That's the case with any kind of, usually one pot pan stuff, right? It kind of happens typically like wok stuff or...
Yeah, so you get it all prepped, and then you just fly.
This is the time-consuming part of it. Once it starts cooking, it's... rather fast.
All right, and we have consumed what? 5 minutes? 10 minutes?
Say hi. You gonna eat some fajita? Yeah.
All right, now, hot pan, cold oil, food won't stick. Remember that, Jax.
Hot pan,
cold oil, food won't stick.
Look how hot it is.
It's a little hot. Yeah, it's a little too hot.
Smoking.
It's
getting hot in here. Fajita.
Yeah.
Ay, ay, ay.
All right, so what you're going to do now is, I'll lead it off a bit. We're going to put the chicken in. All right.
Oh, chicken first. Okay.
Yeah, chicken first. Yeah, usually they do vegetables, but this one does chicken first. That's what we're doing. Now, where did I get this recipe? I'm going to show you where I got the recipe. Off the back of the envelope. And I find the best recipes are on the backs of boxes and envelopes.
Well, they probably...
All right, now, the chicken is not, it's done on the outside. There's still a little bit of raw on the inside. You can kind of see it. But we have to cook vegetables, so it has plenty of time to cook. Okay, Coralie.
What?
Here you go, sweetie pie. How about you put these in the pan?
Yes.
You have a
chef in training.
Yes. Put a whole bunch like this.
Oh,
there you go.
Throw
it in there.
All right, put them in. Put them in. Oh, you're such a good.
She's an excellent helper. Both
of them. That's a good cook. Put onions in.
Oh, go bring the onions.
I'll put some. You put some. Okay, honey. Here we go. Ready?
Throw them in.
Onions. Now the magic. Are you ready, Jack? This is like such a cheat.
You're doing a cooking show at four.
At
4 years old, on your own, on a cooking show.
Okay, here it goes. The magic.
Wow.
And there we go. And now it's just going to cook. I would think maybe for another 5 minutes, just until the vegetables are nice and tender. So here we are. We've been off camera for about 5 minutes, and we still have nice crispy vegetables. The peppers are not done to death, and neither are the...
Cebolla. I just looked up onion and peppers in Spanish. Cebolla y pimiento.
Oh! Cebolla y pimiento.
Fajita pollo. De pollo.
There you go.
Something like that.
So anyway, all right, so now we are ready. I'm gonna turn it off. Here we go. It is now off. And it's time to eat. Normally you put them in a dry frying pan. So if you have two frying pans, you can always stick another frying pan on. And you just throw them in, heat them up, and then you're ready to rock and roll. Okay, Jax.
All right.
Okay.
Should we make one?
Yes.
Or
make
one. That?
All right, now, we have to get the fixins. So here are the fixins that I have.
Are those cebolla y pimiento?
Cebolla y pimiento.
I'm going to be so fluent by the end of this.
Salsa. A guacamole. You suppose guacamole is guacamole in Spanish?
Sure. I don't even know if it is.
It's guacamole.
Traditional.
And we have some sour cream. And somewhere around here we have some cheese. All right. And all we need now is a spoon to make it all work. And then, and if you don't want to use that sauce, then I will put on the fajita mix. But you have to have lots of spice. Not lots, but you have to have chili and I think cumin and paprika and garlic.
The more spices, the more expensive.
Yeah.
I guess, I
so, say. And you just, you know, to carry that stuff around with you when you're traveling is just silly. So, easier to go to the soup aisle, find the fajita, and if you can't find it, ask for it. The skillet. So, you want McCormick, skillet sauce, fajita. And buy yourself two envelopes.
And this is, you know, he doesn't know how to do this. I know that. So even though he grew up in Southern California, for some reason, it's never rolled his own. So you fold it over, then you fold it again, like origami, my husband. And then you fold it this way.
And then you have little, it doesn't fall out the bottom.
Shall I eat it or do I have to wait for you?
No, you go ahead, eat it. Ready? And tell me how delicious it is.
Mm.
It's good, isn't it?
That's really good.
And there we are.
You like it?